championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers, and it's game day. Lakers versus Pelicans, biggest game of the season so far for the Lakers. Standings on the line, the Lakers currently sitting in the 9th seed. The Pelicans could move up if the Lakers do lose tonight to them, but we also have to get into a little bit of news about Wenyen Gabriel. Joining me is Mark Gunnels. Mark, how are you doing, man?
Hey, I'm doing good, man. How about you?
Doing well. It's a tense day around here. I mean, we know how important this game is for the Lakers tonight. But first, a little bit of news to get into. This question has been asked quite a bit. Is Wenyen Gabriel eligible for the playoffs? And I actually talked about a week ago about this, and we had said at the time that what we could find was that he indeed was eligible. However, after doing some checking, and I've checked in with a few different people, he is not playoff eligible for the Lakers currently. So first and foremost, Mark, how big of a difference maker has Wenyen Gabriel been for the Lakers so far in his short stint?
Yeah, he's like the only guy as far as bigs go that's young, energetic. He's athletic. He brought a new type of energy to the team on both sides of the court. I mean, we saw games where he was knocking down jumpers and, you know, affecting the glass and altering shots and stuff like that. He's a very versatile guy. He can switch and guard guards at times too on the switch. So yeah, it's definitely would be unfortunate if he's not available for the playoffs, because I do like the athleticism aspect he brings to the front court.
So if he was eligible, they would certainly be playing him. And on that front, there is some good news. He is not currently eligible because he's on a two-way contract. Last year, the NBA made two-way contracts playoff eligible due to COVID and all that stuff. And it sounded like that was happening this year as well. There was a point where they completely got rid of the games restriction for two-way players. And so it sounded as though it was moving in that direction, but they never went ahead and made them playoff eligible. However, for the Lakers, all that really means functionally is they have to waive somebody. They have to waive somebody in order to open up a roster spot for Wenyen Gabriel. And like you said, he's been enough of a difference maker to where I believe that they will do that. Particularly, the cost is fairly minimal. You're talking about converting him to a standard contract just for essentially the postseason, which obviously isn't as expensive as waiving a player, paying that player to go away, and then signing somebody else for the entire remainder of the regular season, as you might do, say, on the buyout market or something like that. So this is a fairly easy move to make functionally. You waive one player, you give Wenyen Gabriel that spot, and off you go. So assuming that he is going to be part of the future here, particularly into the postseason, that's what we should expect to happen. But then that begs the question, Mark, who could you see the Lakers waiving in order to keep Wenyen Gabriel around? I would have to imagine that's the decision they will make, is to keep Wenyen Gabriel, but who gets the axe as a result?
And see, that's a tough one. I was thinking maybe somebody like an Avery Bradley could be a candidate there. You know, obviously, he hasn't been quite the same guy that we were accustomed to a couple years ago. The rotation outside of the perimeter has been really kind of shaky as far as consistency. He hasn't been knocking down his threes. His defense isn't quite the same. So I wouldn't be shocked if that would be a candidate.
That's one that could potentially be there. Now, he's been in and out of Frank Vogel's rotation, but maybe he's somebody they look at. Kent Bazemore could be another one. Trevor Ariza, though we've seen how much the Lakers have struggled with their lack of quality wing depth. It's part of why you're seeing Wenyen Gabriel, Stanley Johnson, these guys get so many minutes. So maybe he's somebody that sticks just to have another player with that frame that Ariza does. But DeAndre Jordan was kind of the clear answer for a while there, and then he wound up getting sent out. He wound up getting waived before March 1st, which allowed him to then go sign with the Philadelphia 76ers. So now I think the next guy for me is probably Bazemore, but will be an interesting decision for the Lakers to make. Maybe it is an Avery Bradley. Maybe it's an Ariza. Maybe somebody else that they start to look at. I think the one thing that's clear, though, is they have to keep Wenyen Gabriel, assuming he continues playing the way he has for the remainder of the season. They need what he brings too much.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's been a stay in the rotation. I mean, he's been a guy that's getting constant, consistent minutes. He's bringing energy. And he's one of those guys that, you know, out of college, I mean, he was a pretty big name. And now he's getting his kind of second chance. Mm-hmm. And he's going to take full advantage of it. So he's a guy that's really hungry, too. So there's no lack of motivation, if you would, for a Wenyen Gabriel too as well.
And that's exactly what the Lakers have been needing, right? Is that kind of fire, that drive, that energy. We haven't seen that every single night from this team. It's part of the reason why they're in the position they're in now. They had some no-show performances against a few of the weaker teams in the NBA and dropped games that, frankly, they shouldn't have. Before we get into the Lakers versus Pelicans preview, I do want to mention that we are going to once again have our live play-by-play. You can watch the game right along with us, all on the same screen, and listen to our play-by-play of tonight's Lakers versus Pelicans game. Use the link in the description. I'm going to put it right in there. Now remember, the room is capped. It does get capped. It's possible that you don't make it in. So use that link in the description. Get all set up early and get ready for Lakers versus Pelicans, and you can enjoy it with us. So Mark, let's talk first about the line. You were talking, I guessed, I hadn't looked at the lines, and I guessed that the Lakers were favorites in this one, and you said that is not the case. Instead, the Pelicans are actually the favorites in this game.
Yeah, as of right now, it's Pelicans minus 2.5. And for the reason that you thought the Lakers were going to be favorite, I actually like the Lakers here plus 2.5. I actually think they're going to win the game outright, but I'm not going to be that risky and tell you guys to go on the money line. Just take the plus 2.5. I think with this game being so big, the Lakers have had, 3 days off? Mm-hmm. The Pelicans just played last night. I think they're going to be well-rested. They're going to be fresh. And obviously, LeBron is going to be fresh. I mean, he hasn't played since that Cleveland game, which felt like a month ago now.
Right.
So I think you're going to see a motivated LeBron. He's going to put on a show. And yeah, I'm like Lakers plus 2.5. And I like LeBron on player prop as well, too.
I keep thinking, Mark, I mean, this is, and we'll get into LeBron's numbers in a minute here, but all season long, every time we've said, okay, the Lakers, you know, they just suffered a bad loss. There should be a bounce back the next game. They're going to be upset. They're going to come out angry. They're going to come out motivated. They've largely fallen flat. And so that's the only thing that worries me in terms of do they come out and compete in this game is we've seen them, when you would expect a team to step up, do the exact opposite. I'm hoping, though, based on the rhetoric we've heard from the Lakers, Russell Westbrook saying they have to treat this like a playoff game, it's do or die, that all that stuff, I have to imagine they show up tonight for this one. And I think that with the way their offense has been clicking over the last four games, they have the third best offensive rating in the NBA. Never thought I'd be saying that, at least not. And once we got into the mid part of the season and we saw how things were going, wouldn't have guessed that at this point. Now we'd be saying that over any stretch, the Lakers would have the third best offense. But over the last four games, they are third in offensive rating. We've seen the ball moving around the perimeter. We've seen them finding corner threes. That's given me some optimism as well. But the last time the Lakers played the Pelicans, it didn't go so great. They got blown out. So it's going to be interesting to see where this all plays out. As you mentioned, LeBron James, a lot is going to be determined by him. We are assuming he plays tonight, was listed as questionable. We would imagine, though, he's probably going to play. So where are we at in terms of his stats? What do we need to hit? And do you think he hits the over?
So I got the over on his assist tonight.
Okay.
Right now I got it at 6.5.
Oh.
The last time he played against Cleveland, he had 12 assists, and he still scored 38 points. So even though he was still a big-time scorer, he was still able to dish it out and get double-digit assists. So I think at 6.5, I think that number is really too low. So I like the over on that as well.
All right. Yeah, I think that's going to be a thing. I think the Lakers realize how big this is. I think LeBron does, and I think he's going to step up. I think he's going to step up in this one. Now, I want to mention in terms of the standings, right now, the Lakers are in the 9 seed. Right now, again, they are the 9 seed as of this moment. However, the Pelicans, just a half a game back, and then because the Spurs actually beat the Pelicans last night, so the Pelicans, Brandon Ingram has been dealing with a hamstring injury. The Pelicans did not play him last night, in part so they could play him tonight against the Lakers, and they could have a rested Brandon Ingram. So the Pelicans, a little bit of strategy there. Remember, the Pelicans, if the Lakers pick falls 1 through 10, the Pelicans get it. So they've got a little extra motivation in making sure that the Lakers lose this game tonight, not to mention all the drama surrounding the Anthony Davis trade and the fact that they want to be in the play-in tournament and not get bounced out. There's a lot on the line tonight for this one. But the Pelicans just half a game back. And this is where it gets a little tricky. The Spurs right now, just a game and a half back of the Lakers. The Spurs have a matchup with the Houston Rockets coming up. And should the Lakers lose tonight, the Spurs could then be within half a game, assuming they beat the Rockets, of knocking the Lakers out of the play-in altogether. So there is a lot on the line here. in this game. I've been looking at this game, Mark, and let me know if you agree with this. I've been looking at this as the Lakers losing this game is a bigger deal than the Pelicans winning this game in terms of the reaction that we're going to see around the league. Do you think that's an accurate statement?
Oh, yeah, 100%. Because like you mentioned, the Spurs are probably going to beat the Rockets. So the Lakers lose this game. Now you're really in danger of missing the play-in altogether. So I can only imagine the reaction if they lose this game, especially considering they've had the rest. LeBron's going to play. So there's really no excuses. So, yeah, they have to win this game. It's really huge.
Also, when we look ahead at the schedule, right now, the Lakers, the most winnable games left on the schedule are two games against the Pelicans, today's, and then Friday's, and then a matchup with the Oklahoma City Thunder. Every other game is a very, very difficult one on the Lakers slate, so you have to take advantage of these opportunities to win a game. And again, the Pelicans really, really took out frustration on the Lakers last time around. It was not close, so I'm not saying that this is going to be an easy matchup at all, but this game and Friday's game looks more winnable than some of the other games left on the Lakers schedule. So you have to take advantage of the opportunities that are in front of you and get the win right here tonight. Should the Lakers get the W, that will move them to 2.5 games ahead of the Pelicans, and that would also drop the Pelicans to just half a game ahead of the Spurs. So there's a lot on the line here tonight. Oh, Mark, I'm going to be stressed during this one. This is going to be a stressful game, but end of the day, you've got the Lakers walking away with the win.
Yeah, I think Lakers win this game. I really do. I think LeBron brings it home. I think Westbrook is going to have a good game as well. And like you said, they've talked about how important this game is. They're going to treat it like a playoff game. So I'm going to go with the veteran team here in this matchup.
I agree. Cautiously optimistic. I'm going to agree and hope that the Lakers can get the win. We should note that the Pelicans have listed CJ McCollum and Jonas Valanciunas as questionable for this game with a couple of ailments. I don't know how accurate that is. I'm going to assume they play. I'm wondering how much of that is just kind of gamesmanship heading into tonight, just trying to get the Lakers to not really be able to game plan as much for them. That kind of stuff becomes a factor here. So until we get something a little bit more concrete about them having real specific injuries that could really keep them out, I'm going to assume those two guys are in and playing, because the Pelicans, again, they have every reason in the world to hope for a win tonight against the Lakers.
Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, if you're questionable and this is like a playoff type of game, you're going to do whatever it takes to get on that court tonight, especially against the Lakers. So I think they're going to play.
All right, we'll see how it goes. Lakers Nation, let us know what you think. Again, don't forget to come join us for the live play-by-play during the game. Use that link to playback in the description down below. Let's hope the Lakers can get a win. Till then, everybody, we'll see ya and stay safe.